Hi, everyone, and welcome to our first webcast of April. And this entire year, we have really been focusing on keeping you updated on standard resources and helping you to explore those resources to support standards implementation in your school or district. All year, we have been focusing on the same two essential questions. What resources are available to Kentucky educators for implementing the Kentucky academic standards? And then how might schools and districts utilize these tools in their implementation plans? And as a part of our Spring 2020 Professional Learning Series, we have webcasts that typically take place on the first and third Thursday of the month. We have a digital professional learning opportunity that we release on the fourth Thursday that's tied to the topic of that month. And then finally, we have an ongoing topic study in a Google Classroom that's really focused on building a culture of learning, kind of looking at the role PLCs play in that. And just so you know, if you were not a part of that study, we are in the process of packaging that up for you so that you have access to all of those tools and resources to replicate that either to go through it yourself or with your school or district. This spring, each month, we have been focusing on a different content area. And now we are in April, and so we are focusing on mathematics. Now, one thing I do want you to take note of, this month is a little bit different from the other months. There are actually 5 weeks in May. So our webcast, the one we're doing today, is technically on the second Thursday. And then the third Thursday will be the other webcast. And then the fourth Thursday will release that digital professional learning opportunity. So they're back to back to back. And that's different than we've done in other months. But we just wanted to make sure we honored spring break because we know many of you took spring break this first week of April. So joining me today are Aaron Chavez and Maggie Doyle, two of our math consultants from the Department of Education, and I am going to turn it over to them as they're going to describe for you some of the resources we have available to help with implementation of the KAS for mathematics.
Thank you, Misty. So the first thing that Aaron and I would like to invite you to do is to visit kystandards.org if you haven't already. All of the resources that we're going to talk about today are housed on kystandards.org, and we would invite you also to subscribe when you get there. The newsletters that come out, I know, are even so helpful for me in my role, but I know for those of you who work with educators around the state and even as a classroom teacher, you're going to get a lot of really valuable information in there on where we're headed as a profession and what's coming up for education in Kentucky.
And Maggie, I would just like to add to that, when you sign up for the newsletter, that's how you get notification of when new resources have been added to KY Standards.
Definitely. So our mathematics resource page is here. And we are, you know, always working to see what we can add to this to support Kentucky teachers. So as we go through here and we talk and talk about some five things to know before you go, when we get there, we'll talk about some resources that are going to be added coming up. So this standards resources page is where you can find access to everything we're going to talk about today. And we're going to take you through what resources are available and the purpose of those resources, who it's designed for, the audience that you might want to take part in actually utilizing the tool, who you might want to lead the work of utilizing the tool, and how and when you would use this resource in your school. Just some suggestions on how you might make it work. We know that you guys locally have plans for what's going to happen in your professional learning and professional growth for your educators. So make this work, and we are definitely flexible. We're just going to give you a couple of ideas about how that might happen.
So one of the first places you might want to start is the resource of the Standards Implementation Guide. And so it offers guiding questions to assist educators on figuring out their next steps on implementation of the Kentucky Academic Standards for Mathematics. Who can use this? All shareholders. This is a perfect tool to use during your PLC, or as you are thinking about just professional learning upcoming for the summer or for the next school year, you might want to think about, where do I start? You know, am I just starting to getting to know the standards and I need to look at the modules, or have I already done the modules and I need to think about next steps?
So as Erin just mentioned, so we have modules that are designed to help you learn about the Kentucky Academic Standards for Mathematics. So the very first one on those is the Getting to Know Your KAS module, and that's made up of 7 sessions, and they're really designed to happen and occur in a 45-minute or so department or team meeting or PLC, whatever you have, whatever structure you have in place in your school or your district. So we envision that instructional leaders, teacher leaders might facilitate this work, but we really want the audience to be anyone who's gonna work with your students to help them be successful in grade level content. So we'd like for you to consider your interventionists in the audience. Make sure that they have the seat at the table for these. Some of them might have so much extra math training that they can even be a facilitator through this process. Include your special educators. Anybody who's going to work with your students to master this grade level content really needs to get to know the Kentucky Academic Standards. They need to know what that content is, and they need to know all the supporting components within that document and how they can use those to help support student success. So they are designed to be these 45-minute PLC sessions. There's a facilitator's guide already written for you. You can use it as a script if you'd like. Please don't feel tied to it or married to it as a script, but it's there to support you if you need it. There's also a PowerPoint that's already been created. And within a lot of the sessions, there are discovery tasks available by grade level so that as your teachers are learning and going through this learning process of getting to know the standards, they have the opportunity to actually experience what that looks like. And so that was really important there. So as we talk about the next several resources, we're just going to kind of bookend this by coming back to getting to know the standard, because as we talk about a couple of things coming up, just think back to how much more powerful they'll be if your teachers have already had a chance to get to know the standards really well.
Another tool or resource that's very valuable is breaking down a standard. And so there could be a standard that your team, maybe it's fourth or whichever grade level, and you think about, okay, we're getting ready to teach fractions, but my understanding is different from your understanding of fractions. And so what this tool does is that it takes it through each component of the architecture of the Kentucky Academic Standards for Mathematics, and you dive deep. It has gotten questions about the target of the standard, what do the clarifications look like, what SMPs will your students engage in, what's the coherence, what's the prior knowledge that they've been working on, and where are they going afterwards. Just a very valuable tool when you're trying to think about the instructional implications for students. Who can utilize this tool? Really anyone, but principals, instructional leaders, and teachers for sure. And then again, perfect opportunity to utilize this tool in a PLC. Definitely don't want to do this for every single standard. And so Maggie and I actually are choosing a standard per grade level or conceptual category in high school, and we'll be releasing those at the end of April.
And Erin, that segues great into mine, because alongside that breaking down a standard resource per grade level or conceptual category that we'll be releasing, we'll also be releasing a sample assignment review protocol. So the mathematics assignment review protocol is intended to help teachers, leaders, any stakeholders answer the question, does this task or lesson or assignment, whatever that learning experience might look like, does it give the students the opportunity to meaningfully engage in grade appropriate content? Because we know that if students don't have the opportunity to engage in grade appropriate content, then they can never master grade appropriate content. So this would be great for instructional leaders, for teachers, for those other stakeholders that we've talked about who are supporting our students. Because what this tool is going to do is it's going to build off those guiding questions, again, hitting a lot of the same things that the breaking down tool does. And again, hinging on getting to know those standards and knowing what's in the document to support you. But should happen in about a 45-minute PLC. And the discussions that you have in your PLC around this tool are going to be so powerful. This is a great place to say, well, okay, but I don't know if full intent of the standard. So who of us has a different task, something else that we can pair with this to make sure that everything is getting covered and that there aren't any gaps? Or there might be some tweaks. You might just want to change the wording of a question to engage in a different mathematical practice. And so this is going to be a really powerful tool for your educators to utilize to make sure that the students are getting those opportunities that we desperately want to build for them in our classroom instruction.
Okay, the next resource, it's a mathematics instructional alignment rubric. And so maybe you all are, maybe districts are looking at purchasing a new program, or maybe you're looking at your existing program that you have currently, and you need to make sure that it's aligned to the Kentucky Academic Standards for Mathematics. Well, this tool does that. It takes you through a process to make sure that not only the assessments and the exit tickets or formative assessments or tasks, but that they are all aligned to the standards. And if they're not, then that gives you areas of where you need to supplement to make sure the alignment is there. Again, this is not something that you could do in a PLC. This would have to take multiple days because it's a pretty in-depth process. Our recommendation is instructional leaders, but also teacher leaders, because you want them to have that buy-in, especially if they're the ones that are implementing that program. Again, very valuable, but very in-depth learning. So a couple of days of professional learning for sure.
Excellent. And so as we think about how all of these resources really support getting to know the Kentucky Academic Standards for Mathematics, we think about how we want all stakeholders to have a seat at that table. So the next resource is one that I love because we got to work with Kentucky teachers on this last summer to develop this. So it's really excited to see it out there now, are the Standards Family Guides. So the Kentucky Academic Standards Family Guides are available in English and Spanish. So what a great tool to have to support your students there. And they were developed to help families, and by families, we mean anybody who's working with your student to help them be successful. If that's parents, if that's guardians, if that's families, if that's caregivers, in some way, we want everyone to have the opportunity to familiarize themselves with the content of each grade level standards. So the guide contains an overview for reading and writing, for mathematics, for science, and social studies. So each grade level has all of those already included. And this is, again, share it far, share it wide. It's for all stakeholders, anybody who is going to support those students. So what a great resource for building that community of support around our students. There are guiding questions on there, and it's a really powerful tool written with families in mind about what they can do at home to support what's happening in the classroom. And especially if those classroom opportunities aren't happening in the way that they traditionally have, how can we keep those lines of communication going and build that support for families? So you might use this for family math or literacy nights, for back to school nights, parent teacher conferences, and really encourage your educators to share them in any correspondence that they have with families, because opening those lines of communication are just going to make it easier to build that community around our students and help each child be successful.
So thank you, Maggie and Erin, for sharing those resources with us today. Five things to know before you go. Just like they said earlier, we really encourage you to sign up for kystandards.org. It's where you're going to be able to get a lot of content-specific updates. Our next webcast is going to be on April 16th, where we're going to focus on gaining clarity around the KAS for Mathematics through PLCs, highlighting really two of the tools that they talked about today and how they work together to help design instruction for our students. And then that digital professional learning will be available on KY Standards on April 23rd. coming soon also will be the Family Math Night resources that Aaron and Maggie have worked really hard to put together for us. And just know, if you've signed up for the Standards newsletter, you will receive an update of when those resources are available. And then finally, we just wanted to remind you that the curriculum design and implementation guidance, which was a part of our March leadership meetings, that is also now available on KY Standards as well. So thank you all for your time, and we hope to see you back here on April 16th.